Hello and welcome to the next episode of my channel, where I'll be taking up the poem Rain on the Roof, written by Coates Kinney. So the basic theme, as you can see from the name of the poem, is to feel nature, to admire the beauty of nature through the rain. How people, you know, nature loving people, how they love to listen the pitter patter of the rain falling on the roof. This is the first theme. And the second theme which the poet is trying to convey through this poem is that nature is not the same for everyone. To someone it can be kind enough, and to someone it can be harsh at the same time. For example, when it is raining, some of us like to hear the sound of the rain lying on our cottage chamber bed, whereas at the same time there might be people who might be suffering outside without a roof over their head when it is raining. So let's start this poem. When the humid shadows hover over all the starry sphere, and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss it is to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. So humid shadows is a metaphor which means dark clouds. So the poet is trying to say that when dark clouds cover the starry sphere is a metaphor as well as alliteration. Starry sphere over here means sky. So when the dark clouds cover the sky, all of a sudden the entire environment becomes melancholic, becomes sad, gently weeps in rainy tears. This is personification. No one is weeping. It is raining. So what do the first four lines mean? That when dark clouds cover the sky, all of a sudden the entire atmosphere becomes very dark. So darkness is synonymous to sadness. And then it starts crying. In other words, it starts raining. But then at that moment, it is a blessing to lie down on a pillow of a cottage chamber. Cottage chamber is alliteration. And lie listening is again alliteration, to the patter of the soft rain overhead. So at that point of time, it is a blessing to lie on the cottage chamber bed and listen to the sound of the rain falling on the roof. All right? Yeah. Every tinkle on the shingles. Shingles are the covering of the roof, the rough covering of the roof, has an echo in the heart. Okay? Every tinkle, tinkle is onomatopoeia. It is a sound word. So with every raindrop falling on the shingles of the roof, there is an echo in the heart. Echo in the heart, again it's a metaphor. It means old memories bounce back and come back to you. And a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start. And a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof. So what happens when the raindrops fall on the roof? All of a sudden, we start imagining of lot of stuffs. We start remembering lot of our fancies and dreams. And at the same time, all the old memories, recollections, they come back to us. But they don't come back to us one by one. They weave their air threads. They weave their air threads mean they all come together like a net. As I listen to the patter, patter is again onomatopoeia, of the rain upon the roof. So again, what do the first and the second stanza mean? That when the dark clouds cover the sky, all of a sudden the entire atmosphere becomes very melancholic. And then it seems as if the environment is crying. At that point of time, it's a blessing to lie on the cottage chamber and listen to the patter of the rain. Now, with every sound of the raindrop, the poet remembers his old memories and his fancies all come back to him. We say that an empty mind is a devil's workshop. So here the poet is lying vacant with no thought at all. And as he's listening to nature, he starts thinking about his fancies. He starts thinking about his memories. Now, one very significant memory comes to his mind, and that is of his mother. It's very clear that his mother is dead, and that's why she comes to him only in his memory. Now, in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone, to regard the darling dreamer ere before she left them till the dawn. So, what memory of the mother comes into his mind? As she used to come and check him and his brothers and sisters. So, darling dreamers is alliteration here, meaning his brothers and sister. Every before she left them till the dawn. So, how she used to come and check, like every mother does at night, whether the child is sleeping properly or not. So, this single memory comes to him of his mother, how she used to tuck him and his siblings to bed before she went to sleep herself. Oh, I feel her fond look on me. I remember, the poet remembers, how fondly she used to look on them. As I list to this refrain. So as you know, refrain is a repeating sound. So here, refrain is the sound of the rain. So as the poet is listening to the refrain, that is the sound of the rain, which is played upon the shingles, which is played upon the roof by the patter of the rain. So, rain or nature brings back all the memories, fond memories, especially of his mother, to the poet. So, I hope you have understood. Do like the video and do subscribe my channel. Thank you.